Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, the place for bosses and business owners who want to show up consistently, creatively, and most importantly, through their content. So last year, I posted a video for you about how to post for free from your desktop to Instagram. However, now that it's 2020, I really wanted to update this video for you because last year when I created the video, I spoke about Buffer as the platform of choice, but I no longer use Buffer myself. And in fact, I think there's a much simpler solution out there for all of us. And again, it's free and I will be walking you through it in this video. So I do have a new favorite platform that I use that I love to post from, which means no more posting from your phone, no more fat thumbs, no more annoying trying to find your hashtags on the go. This is from the desktop, so that's easy. You're in a lot more control and you can schedule out as much content as you want for as long as you want. As someone who is scheduling a ton of content every day for both myself and my clients, I simply prefer using the desktop to do that kind of work. It's simpler, it's easier, everything's in one place. It really stops me scrolling the platform because that's what happens when I go into Instagram. I open it and I literally forget why I'm there. And then I have to go searching for hashtags, I have to go searching for the post, or I have to write the post from scratch in the platform. And it's just not particularly user-friendly, I don't find. So to be able to do this from a desktop allows me to stay focused, allows me to actually get a lot more done. And so today I want to walk you through Facebook Creator Studio. Guys, before we go on, if this sounds like the place for you, make sure that you hit the thumbs up button below to let me know that you love this content and also subscribe to the channel because I'm putting out social media and content creation tutorials, tips, tricks, and hacks every single week. So you need to be here on this channel to learn how to show up every single day consistently and creatively. Okay, so without further ado, come with me over to the desktop and I'm going to show you how you can schedule for free to Instagram from your desktop. Okay, so here we are on Facebook and I'm going to show you how to use Facebook Creator Studio. So what you want to do is go to your business page in Facebook. So this is obviously mine, 11 Lights Media. And we want to go up to the bar across the top here. And you'll notice that mine says Creator Studio here. Some of my clients actually have it in this little drop-down part here, so just be sure to check that if yours isn't sitting directly across here in the toolbar. So we want to click on Creator Studio. So now that we're on Facebook Creator Studio, you'll see this little Instagram icon up the top. You need to click that to attach your Instagram profile to it. Now you need a business Instagram profile or you need a creator account to be able to attach it to Facebook Creator Studio. So it will basically prompt you through the steps once you click on that. And if you've got a completely different account that you want to attach, you can, you just need to follow the correct prompts with that. So what I want to show you today is a little bit of the functionality because it's really awesome. It looks a little bit messy and complicated when you come in, but it's actually really good. So you can see here that you can segment by the type of content that you're putting out. So you can see here's all my videos, here's all my photos, any carousels that I've put together. And you can see here that it gives you the likes and the comments on those as well. And then it also gives you stats for your stories and also for your Instagram TV. So it's a really good way of seeing at an overview what's working and what isn't. And then when we come back to all content here, I can go into the individual post status and see what I've published. I can see what I've got scheduled, if there's anything in draft, and also if you've archived anything, and then you can also select certain date ranges as well. Then we've also got our insights bar here too, which you can pop through and see, you know, profile visits, basically any of your call to actions that you have on Instagram, how many accounts you've reached, how many impressions,
And really, it's going to be different for everybody as to what you need from that. I don't often look at the insights on Facebook Creator Studio. I tend to look more at the insights directly on the Instagram app itself. And then also, you can have the breakdown here of when it's the best time to post. So I like the day and hour one because you can actually see here a little bit more of a specific hourly breakdown, whereas on the Instagram app, it gives you every 3 hours of, you know, when the best time to post is, but this is segmented by the hour, which is fabulous. And then again, the city's down the bottom. So we're just going to focus on the actual posting of the content today. Remembering that Facebook Creator Studio is free. It will take you a hot second to get used to it. Once you've done it a couple of times, you'll be good to go. So what I like to do is click create post, and you'll see here that you can either choose the Instagram feed or Instagram TV. Now let's talk about Instagram TV for a second. Okay, so in Instagram TV, when you come in and add a video to it, you can pick the cover thumbnail similar to on the desktop. You'll see here that we can actually upload a custom image. So that's all the same. And then we can add a title and a description on the mobile, same as on the desktop here. And you'll notice on the mobile view here that we can actually add to series, which is underneath the title and the description. We can create a series and we can add to it. So if you've got a series that you want to do about anything, maybe I've got a series that I want to run about how to create content for Instagram, then I can turn that into a series. But if you're posting from Facebook Creator Studio, you don't have that option. So it's not a big deal, to be honest, but I just wanted to point that out because it is one limitation that I've found. Everything else between the mobile and the desktop is virtually the same. I can share a preview to my feed. I can also post to my Facebook page from the desktop here as well. So just note that there are a few little extra things I can do via desktop, but other than that, it's basically the same. So let's upload something just so that I can show you how it works. Now, what happens a lot of the time with your videos is that you'll see here that it populates a screenshot for you. You can just click one of these, or you can make your own in Canva or Photoshop and just upload it as a custom image. I'm not sure why it's flickering, probably because it's uploading. And then we can add a title here, webinar landing page video. We can add a description here. Be sure to check out my webinar. And then we can also add in hashtags. If I had a hashtag list on me, I would add them in. So hashtag webinar, hashtag social media marketing. You know how to add your own hashtags, but it's good because it populates them for you. And so if you are just wanting to add a couple of extra ones, it populates them for you, able to see what's available. So I often have hashtag sets where I don't use the full 30 in the set, but that allows me to tailor the last few specifically to the content that I'm putting out. And then, you know, let's say this was all about YouTube marketing, I could then just see what's available under that tag. So there's YouTube marketing, YouTube marketing 101, YouTube marketing tips, and you can see there that I was able to just choose something based on what's brought up. So that is Instagram TV through Facebook Studio, and you can see down here with the drop down that I can schedule it. So I can schedule it for any time. You just have to make sure if you're scheduling it that it's longer than 10 minutes from the time you schedule. So right now on my computer it's 11:18 a.m. So I just need to make sure that I schedule it for 11:28 or afterwards. And I can also save it as a draft, or I can publish now. So I'm obviously not going to publish this because I don't really want to publish it to my account, but I was just showing you the functionality. Then the other thing that we can do is just post to our Instagram feed. So this is really, really great because you don't get distracted by the Facebook feed. You can literally get on with it and get your own stuff done. So this is really fabulous because the thing I love most about Creator Studio is you can see that I'm not actually in Facebook natively, so I'm not getting distracted by the feed or ads or anything else. I can literally sit here and get work done and not be distracted by it. So let's add some content to the feed. So I'm going to upload an image. So I made this last night. So I'll just use this as an example, and we'll turn this into a carousel. So I just select both at once and it turns it into the carousel for me. You can switch position, but that's not the position that I want. I'm just letting you know that you can switch position of the content if it doesn't upload in the order that you want. You just change the number here. So here we can post to Facebook as well if we want. But then up here we can type in our caption. Now I usually create my captions elsewhere and then import them essentially and copy and paste them so they have all their spacing. So I'm just going to show you the app that I use for that as well afterwards. Okay, so here's my caption. I just copied and pasted from elsewhere. So you can pop that in here. Again, just add in your hashtags down the bottom. Hashtags go here. And you can also add a location. And you are good. And guys, you can also add emojis as well, as I'm sure you probably understand and know. And advanced settings, if you need to attach a business partner to it, because it's a paid partnership, you're able to do that there as well. You're also able to turn commenting off if for some reason it's a sensitive subject and you don't want anybody commenting on it. But for the most part, you shouldn't need to go into advanced settings. So from here, it's exactly the same process as before. You just publish now, you schedule it, or you save as draft. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to publish it now so that you can see what Facebook Creator Studio shows you at your end. And then I will show you Instagram and what it looks like there. So I'm just going to hit publish. And you can see down the bottom that it says it's publishing to Instagram. Sorry if my avatar's in the way. It says your post is publishing to Instagram. Then this feed updates. So you can see that it's there. And then we're going to go into Instagram now. And so you can see that it published there. But I've already published this last night. So I actually need to just go into my app and delete it. Okay, so that's basically the walkthrough of Facebook Creator Studio. It's such a great way to be undistracted and to get all of your content scheduled out. The only other thing I'd recommend to do with this is visually, if you just want to see how things work. So I use Planoly and I use that to plan out my feed just so that I know what it's going to look like. I don't schedule from Planoly. This is just the free version. I literally just use it to see what my feed is going to look like. And so that's when I go back into Facebook Creator Studio and I will push it out. The other app that I want to show you is appsforlifehost.com. You can come in here. You can write your status in Word, in Pages. I use an app called Writed. I just write it in there so I'm not being distracted. I put in the spacing that I want. I put in the emojis that I want. And I hit convert and copy to clipboard. And then I paste that straight into Facebook Creator Studio. And then that way I have all the correct spacing. It doesn't stuff up as it posts. And then I don't have to worry about those captions being unreadable. So that's just another little tip for you. So guys, that's Facebook Creator Studio. I hope you loved having a look around. I really hope you get a chance to use it as well, because it's a great place to come and schedule your posts. You're undistracted. You don't have to worry about going into the app where, honestly, a lot of the time that's where formatting errors happen. That's where your hashtags get stuffed up. That's where you end up in an endless scroll. And so it's really good to just be able to come in here and post your content, schedule it out, and know that it's done. And just before we sign off, I just want to point out that you can do your Facebook post scheduling in here as well.
Well, I hope you found that tutorial super helpful. If you did, leave a comment below and let me know if you're going to start using Facebook Creator Studio, or maybe you already use it. Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And also, if you want further help with your content and social media, I have a free Facebook group. All you need to do is have a look in the description below where the link to the Facebook group is there. And then just fill out the questions and I'll let you into the group. I live stream every single week on other topics other than what I do on YouTube itself. And we go deeper into strategy and mindset and also tactical advice as well. But otherwise, Keep showing up, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.